Earnings. Meanwhile, Godrej Consumer Products also came out with its earnings and the management, we spoke to the management. Let's cut across to that and listen into what the management has to say.
If we start with India, which is about half of our business, we've delivered double-digit growth with about a 15% growth in net profit. And so in India, we've been delivering sustained profitable growth for several quarters now. And so performance is very much on track. And within India, I think what's also encouraging is that gross margins went up by about 100 basis points. And we had a 26% increase in A&P expenses. So we're investing in brand building. Gross margins are going up. And EBITDA growth is ahead of sales growth. So all the P&L metrics seem to be on the right track as far as India is concerned. Across categories, soaps and hair colors and air fresheners did quite well. HI, insecticides a little bit on the softer side. In Indonesia, again, a very strong performance, 14% growth with expansion in EBITDA margin and market share increases in across all our major brands. Africa was actually on the softer side. And within Africa, West Africa and East Africa and the US business did quite well. The South Africa business was a disappointment.
What has been the real impact? You said there were pressure from the macros. What has been the real impact of raw material price increase? What is the, sort of your outlook going forward in terms of when will these prices soften or sort of come down? And you spoke about price hikes. So is that all or are we going to, can we expect a little bit more going forward?
In India, so far we have not seen significant impact of raw material cost increases. The one we worry about actually is crude oil, because palm oil prices are supposedly going to be benign for the next couple of quarters. Crude is an indirect variable which affects transportation and packaging. So far, it hasn't impacted our business because of some of the costs that we already had in the base. In quarter three, we're not planning any price increases at all. In quarter four, we'll have to wait and watch and see what the situation is. The focus so far seems to be on volume growth. The economy is recovering quite nicely. And so I think if this momentum continues, perhaps we may not need to take any price hikes. We'll only see that in a few months.
In the press release, it spoke of some softness as far as the CSD channel is concerned and as well as impact of Kerala floods. Talk to us a little bit about that.
The collective impact of both of these was about 100 basis points as far as our growth in last quarter was concerned. On CSD, we are not very dependent on the CSD channel. It's less than 2% of our sales. I think other players are more dependent on it. With the Kerala floods, it was a one-off event. I think it's behind us now. As far as I see, H2 should be much stronger than H1 on both top line and bottom line growth.
What is the dynamics like between the rural and urban growth? We've seen rural has been ahead of urban for quite some time now. So what were the growth rates specifically for rural and urban, and what is the differential looking like?
Our rural growth rate has been almost 2x of our urban growth. So we are seeing a significantly higher uptick in rural demand as well, and we hope that will sustain in the second half of the year.
How much is all these current innovations contributing to the overall revenue, the new innovation that are happening, the success rate, if you could talk about?
It's a bit early to say, but for the year as a whole, our efforts will be is to have about 30 to 40% of our growth come from new products. The innovations have been very disruptive, particularly in India. We've launched the first powder, powder to liquid hand wash. We've launched a comprehensive male grooming range. We've launched a new insecticide repellent in Indonesia and a slew of new products in Africa. So innovation continues to be a lifeblood, as we say. The momentum will continue and we do expect to invest heavily and drive a lot of growth from innovations.
All right, so that was the GCPL management. The street is certainly not liking the results as the stock is down currently by about 1.7%. And the street has concerns about their HI portfolio, which the management just spoke about. We can also pull out now Hinduja Global. That one came out with its earnings. Mixed bag of earnings for Hinduja Global. The management of the company, Mr. Partha,